Hi, this is a special video for Dobroslav Petrov. He has some issues with car, with potentiometer, with bad combustion, and so on. So let's try to solve this issue. Epa, bratko, da ga rešimo. Well, at first, concerning the potentiometer, you did as I told you to do. You moved the potentiometer all the way up, and then moved it slowly downwards. And that's how you should do. But as I said in that video, you must be extra careful and patient. This takes really so much time. This is a really, really one big time consumer. But either you're going to do it my way and you're going to calibrate your potentiometer, or you're going to drive your car to the dealership and they're going to charge you 600 euros. Now, it's up to you to decide. This way or another. Once you have done the potentiometer, you calibrated it, you're good to go for the next 10 years, at least, or for the next 90,000 miles. It's up to you to decide. But bear in mind, and I repeat, bear in mind that you will have to move it gently as possible. It is extremely, extremely precise work. But it's worth, believe me. So that's for the potentiometer. I know how I was feeling the moment I had to calibrate mine. And now, the second thing. Here, concerning the potentiometer, you did everything as you had to do it. Here, this is contact number one. It's for negative, and the second one is for positive. And you will really have to kick it really as gently, not like this or this. I tightened the screws now. It's going to be like this, a bit. And you then look at the multimeter and bear in mind every movement you make, wait for about 10 seconds. Wait for the ECU to realize that that a change has been made. And that's how you do it. You loosen the screws, you know, I've been explaining that, I don't want to repeat myself. That's concerning the potentiometer. And now, concerning the duty cycle. As you don't have a cat version, the version with a catalyst, then you will have to do your duty cycle here on your EHA. And here you're going to be measuring milliamps. Here, look at the connection. Here, the same thing you did with the the potentiometer. The same thing you're going to be doing with the EHA. You're going to pull the connector a bit, just good enough for the multimeter to stick those two. Now, don't ask me which one is positive, which one is negative, because every time you start and stall the car, the polarity changes. And that's why once you see that polarity and watch at my video on EHA, I'm going to post the link, a card here. And you're going to see how many milliamps. You're going to be measuring milliamps. That's the only way you can do your duty cycle, as you haven't number three connected to the system. And number three is for the Ke Jetronic, for the mechanical injection. As you get your multimeters, then you're going to take your Allen and you're going to do it here. And let me tell you how. Excuse me, really? Sorry, I couldn't find my 3 mils Allen and I took this one. Never mind, you need the 3 mils Allen. And a very important thing, as you are doing the duty cycle this way, don't, and I repeat, don't take off the air filter housing. It has to be on. Everything has to be on. Don't take anything off. Okay. Now, let's presume that here you have hooked your multimeter. You measure milliamps, and now look, you stick here your 3 mils Allen, and the more you turn this Allen key clockwise, this is clockwise, the richer the mixture is going to be, and you're going to get negative milliamps. As for you, go for 0 milliamps on idle, of course, but let those movements not be for here, like this, quarter of a turn or for half of a turn, no, for this much. Literally for this much. And as you do this, as you move this CO screw, then wait for 10 seconds. After those 10 seconds, you can do one throttle blip. So you press the accelerator lever, boom, and then you wait. And look at the multimeter. After you have done it, for those that have a lambda probe, for those, the ideal would be this: these oscillations between -3 and 0. For you that don't have this lambda probe, then go for 0. They say that ideal will be -2. But I would recommend you to go for 0. The more you turn this CO screw counterclockwise, the leaner is going to be the mixture, and your milliamps are going to raise to the positive range. I repeat, this much. just you stick it in and you move it this much, nothing more, and you let it go and wait. Then you count 1, 2, 3 and up to 10, and then a throttle blip. As you're done, you can then someone can help you, use a helper and let him press the accelerator up to, and raise the revs up to 2000. As he raised the revs, then you will have to get between, as I remember, you will see in my video on the EHA, between 2 and 5 milliamps. Go for 3. I really don't know what to say, what to recommend. You can take this average value, and the same thing again. Don't do it fast, just like this, a bit, just a bit, this much, not more, and then you wait. As for that black smoke coming from your engine, the only thing I can say, check either your injectors or your spark plugs. And as for the spark plugs, I think you know that the gap between two electrodes must be 0.8 mils. I'm telling you, if you decide to run your car on gas only, if you decide to run that quasi-fuel called LPG, then you can go for 0.6 mils gap between the two electrodes. You will have to diminish it if it is more than 0.6. Okay, that would be everything what I can tell you. So again, for the black smoke, I think the combustion is not good, and I think you should check either your injectors or check the spark plugs. Something out of those two is a culprit. And that would be everything. So, if you enjoyed this video and if it was helpful, don't click button skip ads, and till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.